lot of jerseys, but these are just the ones that I... So I'm gonna start over here. This one right here, this is my first national camp, the Junior All-American Camp in Virginia. Going to my seventh grade year. That was my first national camp when I really got on the scene like that. Over here, this phenom, this black jersey right here, got ranked number one at both of those camps, so that kinda put me on the map, so that's why I got those up there. Never forget that. Then we got, right here, we got the Fab Frosh camp. Going into my freshman year, the Fab Frosh, I was at the University of Kentucky. And the USA Global Challenge, Phenom 150, Adidas Nations. It's the Oregon All-American jersey. We got a thing called the Oregon-Washington game. You know, Seattle, Portland, Oregon-Washington, that's a big rivalry in the Northwest. So that was my beginning, my eighth grade year. I mean, it was a big game. It was at Lewis and Clark College. A lot of fans. Had 52 in the game. So got this up here. That was big time right there.
Keep talking, bro! Good side!
I've had a friend back in Portland, Oregon, ask me when Nigel was going into the eighth grade, where did I see Nigel going to high school? And I kind of gave him an answer like I really wasn't for sure. And so he mentioned to me about a new program that was in Henderson, Nevada called Findlay College Prep. When Nigel was in a summer tournament going into his eighth grade year, I had a opportunity to meet the coach from Findlay Prep, Mike Peck, at one of Nigel's games. And that was kind of the introduction of Nigel, myself, and Coach Peck to the beginning of Nigel coming to Findlay Prep.
I tell you what, you guys aren't as I am. You know what? I can't light that fire for you. I can't give you my anger, my chippiness, and I can't put it in. If it's not in you, it's not in you.
Over the summer and stuff, I really added a lot to my game. You know, I think I physically matured a lot, mentally matured a lot. And you know, just playing with a chip on my shoulder every time I go out there. And like you said, you didn't get to see me play a lot last year. And that's, you know, same with a lot of other people. So, you know, this year I'm given the opportunity and, you know, I'm trying to make the best of it. Because I feel like, you know, the short stints that I did get last year, I did play pretty well, but it was never like a long stretch of time where I actually got to, you know, show people what I could do. So, you know, including yourself and other people out there, they didn't really get to see me play. So, you know, this year they're gonna see. So this right here is the Deron Williams signature move that Nike does with all their athletes. And basically why we watch this just because, you know, you got to learn from the best, and D. Will is obviously one of the top premier guards in the NBA, and he's a guy I like to steal some stuff from. So I just try to watch, you know, the stuff he does and how he can get certain shots off. I try to watch it as much as possible so I can see it, and then when we go work out, we'll incorporate it so we can just do it and do it enough so you just get fully comfortable so it's nothing to do it in the game.
He can't recover and block my shot. And then I'm straight up into my shot. I'm not leaning to one side. I want to go straight up into my normal jump shot.
Basketball, it's still, at the end of the day, I just, you know, it might be old fashioned, but hard work pays off, you know, and he spent the whole summer in the gym. You know, getting him in the gym day after day after day, at some point, you know, he's not just messing around in the gym. mean, he's doing work.
I think Virgil was Nigel's only coach probably up until seventh grade, and then he started playing on some other teams, and then going into eighth grade, he played on a 17-under team, which is the first time he was really coached by somebody else. So I would say in those earlier years, there was those father-son disputes, more with Nigel's immaturity, being a kid growing up. And since he's matured, their relationship has grown into, like, best friends.
Watch Papa. Watch Uncle Sony D.
So even though Virgil's his trainer and the main person that he would ever want to be trained by, they still laugh and joke and have a good time. And one of the reasons I think that's possible is because Virgil just follows Nigel's lead. And so when Nigel wants to work out, Virgil's fine to work out with him. And Virgil's never the one saying, hey, let's go get an extra workout in today. It's always Nigel asking to have an extra workout.
Nigel and I, we look forward to our practice time together because it's also a bonding time for Nigel and I. I played basketball, wasn't as good as Nigel at the same age, but I played basketball and I was very okay with my career as a basketball player. This is Nigel's time, this is Nigel's dream, and I think dads who've played should view it differently than living through their kid, understanding it's their kid's time and supporting the kid's dream, whether it's basketball, tennis, or whatever they want to be. In this case, Nigel wants to be a basketball player, so all of my energy is focused to helping Nigel reach his goals.
Wow.
I know that we all get along, like he said, well, and you know, that's a big thing. We always cheer each other. You know, it's gonna get competitive. You know, we get into it in practice, that's for sure. But you know, at the end of the day, you know, we're all brothers, so we work it out.